Hi, I'm Jearl Walker. I'm one of the physics professors here at Cleveland State University. And I want to show you an example of how we solve problems, tricky problems, in physics sometimes. We get stuck when we work with a certain set of dimensions. A simple example. I've got a business card here that Cleveland State gave me. No one's ever asked me for one. So I'm going to use one here. I've cut a hole in the business card. It's a little bit smaller than the US quarter, so the quarter obviously will not go through. Two-dimensional hole. I need to go to a higher set of dimensions to get the quarter to go through the opening. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold the card this way, and then in a perpendicular fashion, and I'll snug the quarter in there. But I'm going to change a two-dimensional opening into a three-dimensional opening by flexing the sides of the card. I don't want to tear the card to get the quarter through. That wouldn't be fair. I just flex the card, and the quarter goes through. Higher dimensions. Here's another example. A CD, a music CD. In the old days, we played music on CDs. I've already folded this piece of cardboard perpendicular ways. The CD will not go through the opening. When it's a two-dimensional opening, I will go to a three-dimensional opening by flexing the sides of the cardboard, and it goes right through. You can try it with other larger objects. Here, in the very old days of music, we played vinyl records. Try to find an aperture, an opening, that's a little bit smaller than an object like this, and get the object to go through by going to a three-dimensional opening. I'd be interested to know what you find. Well, thanks for watching. I hope to see you here again next time on the Flying Circus of Physics. Just remember, physics is everywhere, even in a business card.